दोस्तों नमस्कार। जो लोग बफलो प्रोडक्शन में काम करते हैं उनके लिए कई बार परेशानी खड़ी हो जाती है और उनके लिए रेफरल कोई किताब नहीं मिलती है। दोज ऑफ यू हु आर वर्किंग विद द बफलो रिप्रोडक्शन मेनी टाइम्स फाइंड इट डिफिकल्ट टू हैव सम स्टैंडर्ड टेक्स्ट फॉर रेफरेंस ऑन बफलो रिप्रोडक्शन इन पर्टिकुलर एंड बफलो थीरियोजिनोलॉजी in general. So this is the book which you can refer, the Bubelline Theriogenology. We updated or we launched this book on the International Veterinary Information Service, and and it was completed in 2019. We started in 2012 and we completed it in 2019. So this book has 653 pages, right? And it has many chapters from leading practitioners, scientists and clinicians from around the world. And you this is the website. You can see the http://www.ivis.org oblique library oblique Bubelline / Theriogenology. So you can have this book and it's free to everyone and anyone. You can log into the website, you can download the different chapters, and it's totally free, right? तो इस पुस्तक के बारे में हम आपको थोड़ा और डिटेल में बता देते हैं। इस पुस्तक में this book contains 33 chapters from various leading personalities of the world, and I am the editor of this book. So the first chapter is on anatomy of the reproductive tract of the female and male buffaloes. It has been authored by Professor Carvalho from Brazil, and then the second chapter is from reproductive physiology of the male and female buffalo. This has been authored by Professor R.K. Sharma along with Dr. Jerome and myself. And then the third chapter is effects of environment on buffalo reproduction. This has been authored by Professor Vale, who is a renowned buffalo scientist from Brazil. And then the fourth chapter is from follicular dynamics in female buffaloes, which has been authored by Professor M.K. Awasthi from Madhya Pradesh. And then the estrus synchronization, this chapter in swamp buffaloes, this has been authored by Dr. Yendraliza from Indonesia. And then the gestation and fetal development in the buffalo, this has been authored by myself. Then we have another chapter for approaches for diagnosis of pregnancy in female buffaloes, which have a detailed in-depth view of how pregnancy diagnosis in buffaloes can be done. And we have given a lot of pictures, lot of graphical pictures to depict how pregnancy can be diagnosed in the buffalo. This has been authored by the professor and head of MAFSU Veterinary Gynecology, Professor C.H. Poche, along with me. And then the reproductive application of ultrasound in the female buffalo. This has been authored by Professor George Jambrano from Colombia. And then the next chapter, infectious causes of Bubelline abortions. This has been authored by Professor Mehr Chandani along with Dr. Kashyap. And then the non-infectious causes for Bubelline abortions has been authored by Dr. Kumar from Indian Veterinary Research Institute, India. And then fetal complications of gestation in buffalo, etiology, antenatal diagnosis and management. This has been authored by me. Then another chapter has been authored by me, the maternal complications of gestation in the buffalo. And then parturition and puerperium in the buffalo has been authored by Professor G.K. Das from Indian Veterinary Research Institute, India. Then the former head, professor and head, Professor Chandolia, he has authored the fetal dystrochia and fetal abnormality malformations in the buffalo. He has given a lot and lot of pictures to depict the various abnormalities. And then Caesarean section in the buffalo has been authored by Dr. Dhinsa and Professor Dhaliwal and myself. Then the next chapter, postpartum complications in the buffalo, has been authored by myself and Professor Nitin Markandeya from MAPSU, who has recently retired. And then the etiopathology and therapy of retained placenta and postpartum uterine infections in the buffalo has been authored by Professor Ajavi from Iraq. And then genital prolapse in the buffalo has been authored by me, along with Dr. Talal Abdul Karim from Iran. And then metabolic disorders in the parturient buffalo has been authored by me, along with Dr. Mitesh Gaud, Chandrasekhar Saraswat, and Professor D.K. Bihani. Then the postpartum and summer anistress, prepartal, postpartum and summer anistress in buffaloes has been authored by Professor Shiv Prasad from Pantnagar University, who is the head of the Department of Gynecology, and ovarian pathologies has again been authored by myself. So you will find many things which you were searching in this book. And then the next chapter, genital tract affections in the female buffalo, has been authored by Professor Manik Tandle from Bidar, Karnataka. And jubiline brucellosis has been authored by Patricia Zimmer from Argentina. Then repeat breeding in buffaloes has been authored by me. We have explained the different causes. We have given the suggestions for therapy. And then infertility management in female buffaloes has again been authored by myself. And infertility in the buffalo bulls has been authored by me, along by Professor Pirumal from the ICR Institute on Mithun, and myself, and then two other authors. And semen characteristics and artificial insemination in the buffalo has been authored by Professor Wale, along with me and Miyasaki. Then fixed time insemination in buffaloes, this has been authored by Vittoria Lucia Barrel from Italy, who is one of the renowned personalities for fixed time insemination in the buffaloes. Kindly have a look on his chapter. Then advanced reproductive technologies in the buffalo has been authored by Rufana Duran and PG Duran from Philippines. Reproduction in the swamp buffalo has been authored by Nguyen from Vietnam, and reproduction in wild buffaloes has been authored by Marzian Kramhout from South Africa. So you will find the world's leading professionals contributing chapters in this book, and you will have all answers to all your queries, all your problems you are facing with the buffalo reproduction. Till now, there is no other such publication available. This book was completed in 2019, and it's freely available at the International Veterinary Information Service website. You can download all the chapters. You have to register for the website. The registration is free, and I will strongly suggest all students, all practitioners, all researchers, and all scientists to kindly visit this website, the International Veterinary Information Service. This is a wonderful website. It will give you a lot of most updated books. It will provide you many manuals. It will provide you links for trainings. It will provide you links for the conferences. It will provide many other things. So please do visit. You can download the entire book, even from ResearchGate, from this link. And I will give this link in the description also. Then you can download it from academia, and you can just use this book for your daily practice, for your learning, for your research. And I'm sure that you will find it very useful, and it will be very helpful to all of you. So please do subscribe to our channel, give your likes, give your suggestions, give your comments, and press the bell icon to subscribe our channel, and do share the links to everyone and each and everyone so that he is benefited. So thank you very much. Have a nice day. Bye-bye. Read this book and give your suggestions. Bye-bye.